Hello, everybody. Can you listen to me?
Yes.
Okay. So, good morning, good day, good evening, good night. Welcome to our seminar. And today, we have a pleasure to have as our speaker, our guest, Professor Yuri Bilik from Carleton University, Ottawa. And he will announce his talk. Maybe I could forget at the end of the talk. I just want to make an announcement that the next Thursday, our seminar will start at 10 o'clock, 10 in the morning, in 10 Brazilian time, since we will have a speaker, Professor Arakawa from Japan. Well, in fact, we will have two talks the next Thursday, Professor Arakawa from Japan and Professor Pavel Kolesnikov from Novosibirsk. So the first talk will start four hours earlier than today, and at 10 in Brazilian time. And the second talk will be at 12. So, sorry, Yuri, you can start.
All right. I would like to thank the organizers for the invitation. So far, the talks in this seminar were excellent, and I'm very humbled by the opportunity to speak here. So I will talk about a topic of superconformal algebras. And so the title is Towards Katz-Vandeleur Conjecture.
Excuse me, Yuri.
No, you can't see it.
Yuri, excuse me, just one announcement. I want to advise, say that Yuri cannot see your messages, written messages. So if anybody wanted to ask question, just turn on microphone and ask it, not by written messages.
Yes, I cannot see the chat, right? So I can hear you, but I cannot see the chat. All right. But this is okay, right? So here you can see. All right.
Yes.
Okay, good. So it's about polynomiality. Versus locality. For superconformal algebras. All right, so let's begin with a definition. So a superconformal algebra L is a graded Lie superalgebra, and we write the grading by complex numbers, satisfying the following properties. So one, so L contains a centerless Virasoro as a subalgebra. And here, so we'll denote the basis elements by Ln, and so well-known bracket in the centerless Virasoro is this one. So two. So the grading is given by the joint action of L0. So L0 acts on Lj by multiplication by j. And three, so dimension, right, and support. So this grading supported on a finite number of Z cosets. Right. So, well, it's clear that so here, if we have so one index j, then j plus something will be also in the support. Okay, maybe it's not that clear, but this is true. And so the last is the dimension of Lj. So these dimensions are finite, and these are uniformly bounded. Now, traditionally, the definition of a superconformal algebra also incorporates the property of simplicity, but here it will be more convenient for us to work in a general, more general class and just consider the simple algebras in this class. And these algebras are super generalizations of the Virasoro, and they are of key importance for conformal field theory. All right. So now let us give kind of the main or prototypical example of a superconformal algebra. All right, so the prototypical example of a superconformal algebra is a superalgebra W1M. So here we take the following construction. So we start with lambda being the Grassmann algebra with generators, so with n odd generators, Xi1 to Xi n. So this is an algebra of dimension 2 to the power of n. And so we take R to be the tensor product of Laurent polynomials with lambda. So this is also a commutative superalgebra. And so then W1n is the algebra of derivations of this commutative algebra. And as an R module, so it has the following structure. So it's R times derivation T d dt plus the sum I goes from 1 to n R times the derivation d d xi I, right? And so this d d xi I, sometimes we'll just denote di. Right, so this is a Lie superalgebra. So inside there is a centerless Virasoro that sits here, and one can see, well, L0 will be this minus T ddt, and so it acts in a diagonalizable way, and one can check that all axioms hold, and in fact, this is a simple superconformal algebra. So now we can state Katz-Vandeleur conjecture. So in 1988, Katz and Vandeleur gave a conjectural list of simple superconformal algebras. So this is Katz, Vandeleur conjecture from 1988. So every simple superconformal algebra is a twisted form of one of the following. Algebras. So we have W1m, then we take the derived algebra of S1n, so these are divergence 0 vector fields, then well, there is a version of it S tilde 1 to n. Then there are contact Lie algebra K1n, and maybe some you need also to take a prime here. And there is an exceptional Chen-Katz algebra CK6. And in Katz and van der Leur 88 paper, so they also described possible twisted forms, except that by that time, so Chen-Katz algebra was not discovered yet. And so the original list did not have this one. But so now this is the form how this conjecture is stated. Right. Okay. So the problem is to do this classification. And when we try to classify infinite dimensional objects, one needs to find some sort of regularity in your algebra that will allow you to coordinatize it and basically somehow reduce the problem to a finite dimensional problem. And it was suggested by Victor Katz and his collaborators that a good property for this coordinatization would be locality. So let's talk about locality. All right, so suppose we have a Lie superalgebra. And first we define so a formal L-valued distribution so is the following expression. So it's x of z, which is the sum n in alpha, and so alpha is a z coset in C. So we will be dealing with twisted version. So xn, z to the minus n minus 1. So where z is a formal parameter, and xn's belong to L. So this is what's called an L-valued formal distribution. And so we have a definition. So L is called right. So locality first. So two formal L value distributions. So X of Z and Y of Z are called mutually local. So if there exists a natural number n such that the following expression, so z minus w to the power of n times the formal commutator, so x of z with y of w, so this is equal to zero. And so with this, we have another definition. So a Lie superalgebra L is called Lie superalgebra of formal distributions. If it is spanned by coefficients of a family of mutually local formal distributions. Now, so kind of this is a very common definition, So, however, this definition is a little bit too soft. So, if we just take it at face value, then what we get is that every Lie superalgebra is a Lie superalgebra of formal distributions, because you can do kind of the trivial, so trivial families. So you can take families of the form X of Z, which are sum over N and Z, X, Z to the minus N minus one. So just make it independent of N, right? So, and X runs in over L. So then such families will satisfy this condition when N, with N equals one, right? So it is desirable to strengthen this definition a little bit. And so what we're going to do is we're going to consider two different stronger versions of this definition. So one is a graded version. So we'll say, it's called a graded Lie superalgebra of formal distributions if it's spanned by coefficients of a family of mutually local, and here we add homogeneous. So this would mean that, so for a homogeneous distribution, so here we will have that Xn will belong to L n plus delta, right? So where delta does not depend on N and depends only on the family X of Z, right? So then this example will kind of would not allow this trivial families, and so now this is a more meaningful definition. All right. So before we continue, so I need also one more technical issue to discuss. So we need to talk a little bit about perfect Lie algebras, and a little bit stronger than perfect. So here, so if we take a superconformal Lie algebra, so when is it perfect? So here we can say the following, that superconformal algebra L is perfect. So meaning that L is equal to L prime, the derived algebra, which is the commutant of L with itself. So if it's enough to look at only at L0 components, because we have a diagonal action of the Cartan element on this subalgebra. So this means that we can write L0 is the sum J in C, LJ with L minus J. So the perfectness condition could be formulated in this way. And now we give a definition. So we say that a superconformal algebra L is pluperfect if the following condition holds. If L0 is the sum, so over J except for zero, of LJ with L minus J. Right, so this is something that we will call a pluperfect superconformal algebra. And so now with this, we can state our first main result. All right. So theorem any pluperfect superconformal algebra. Is a graded Lie superalgebra. Of formal distributions. So essentially, so this means that this Lie superalgebra has polynomial structure constants. So this is another, so like this is a way of thinking about these Lie superalgebras of formal distributions. Now, so here we have this condition for being pluperfect. And let me give you an example that shows that this condition is essential. Right. So now I'm going to give this example. Keep in mind that this is not a simple superconformal algebra that we talk about. So suppose we have the following. So suppose we have a Virasoro. And then we have the following bracket. So this is non-super case. So this is, so we have this structure constants and Ln with Gm is minus M plus N. And the interesting bit is here. So we put delta M0 n cubed times f n plus m. So this will be a superconformal algebra, but because of this delta function here, so this is not, so here we will have that locality fails. So this exam, right, and all other Lie brackets that I didn't write are equal to zero. So the locality fails here. And so this example, in fact, originates with the coadjoint representation of the Virasoro. And so, but we note here that the element G0 that really creates this sort of trouble. So this element is not in in L prime, and here, so if we take L prime, then if we throw out G0, then what we get is a pluperfect algebra, and for this locality holds. Because if we don't include G0, then this term that gives trouble would not appear. All right, so let me give you an idea for the proof of this theorem. So here, okay, so one technical remark is that we need the discrete derivative here. So we introduce the operator delta PQ that acts on functions of two variables. And so this equals f of pq minus f of p plus 1 q minus 1. Right, so we take a discrete derivative. And so if we have two fields, then locality can be written using this discrete derivative. So locality can be written as delta pq to the power n applied to the bracket of xp with yq. And that this equals zero. So this is a way how to, another way how to write locality between two fields, so x of z and y of w. And so we need this approach when we prove locality. All right, so here we will use some results from our previous work with Slava Futorny, and we will talk about cuspidal modules. So let M be a weight module for the centerless Virasoro algebra. So then M is called cuspidal. Okay, so if it's a weight module, then we can write it as sum over J in C, so MJ. If the weight, the support, or if the grading is supported on a finite number of cosets, and dimension of MJ are uniformly bounded. And what is important for us is that if L is superconformal, then it is precisely, so L is a cuspidal module with respect to a joint action of the Virasoro. And we proved the following theorem. So this is theorem by myself and Slava Futorny. I think it's 2013. Right. So before I state this theorem, I need to say what is an AV module. So AV modules. So here, so A is Laurent polynomials, and V is the Virasoro, right? And M is an AV module if, so three conditions hold. So one, M is an A module, so as a module over commutative unital algebra. Two, M is a V module, so it's a module for the Lie algebra, Virasoro Lie algebra. And three, we have Leibniz rule. So this means that when we act with a vector field, so here eta will belong to V, and F will belong to A. When we act on F acting on M, then this is the same as applying the vector field to F and multiplying by M plus F acting on eta applied to M. All right, so this is the definition of an AV module. And so we have a theorem that says that so let M be a cuspidal Vir module. Then it has an A cover or AV cover, M hat, which is the following. So it's going to be an AV module, and it's a free A module of a finite rank. So this means that it's has the structure of CTT inverse, which is A tensor times U, where U is finite dimensional. And so M hat is an AV module, and we have a projection. So we have pi, a homomorphism from M hat to M. So this is a homomorphism of Vir module, such that the image of pi is the action of Virasoro applied to M. All right. And so this is the first condition. And the second condition that we will need here, well, actually we need this as well, is the following, that if we take the following operators, LP times LQ, right? So these are LP times LQ. I view this, so these are Virasoro elements, and I view them as operators on M. And then if we take discrete derivative of this, so this will be zero in M for some N. So for every cuspidal module, there exists a constant L, N, such that the discrete derivative of this operator is equal to zero. And so once we have this property, then so the proof of our theorems, right? So we need to prove that we have a finite family of mutually local distributions that will span our superconformal algebra. Right. So here, so what we do is the following. So we take our superconformal algebra L and consider it as a Virasoro module, and we take its cover L hat. So this is not an algebra, but it's a module, AV module for the Virasoro. And then this space has the structure CTT indoor tensor U, where U is finite dimensional, right? And this gives us families, right? So we need to construct families for which we are going to prove mutual locality. So here we get families, and then we apply pi, and we project these families back to L, right? So we're going to get this families U of Z, which is the sum N in Z, UN Z to the minus N minus one. And we need to prove mutual locality of these families. So how do we do this? So we take this operator that let's call it omega N here, which is zero in the module, right? Or it will be zero in L. And so then we take the following. So since L is a Lie superalgebra, so we can take the commutator of omega N with UK, and then, or with maybe not with UK, but with a joint of UK, and apply this to VS. So this is still going to be zero because this operator is zero in L hat. And from here, what one can get is one can get that the discrete derivative of UP, or of the commutator of UP with VQ to some power n prime. So this n prime is bigger than n, so that will be zero. And so this proves locality, and so this can be done in a graded way. And so this shows that any, right, and the condition that Lie algebra should be pluperfect, so it really comes from this condition here, that this pi need not to be surjective in general. And only for this part we can prove that it's pluperfect, but this will be precisely, in our context, will be this commutant L with L. Right. Okay, so this is one part that I wanted to talk. So let me briefly say what's the general outline of the what's the hope, how to prove the conjecture. Right. So the central part of the proof is so we hope is going to be the work of Fattori and Katz, who classified finite superconformal algebras. So Fattori and Katz. So we have classification of finite superconformal, not superconformal, of finite conformal superalgebras. Simple. Right. And of course, to go from superconformal algebras to conformal superalgebras, one needs locality. Right. So here we have this locality that we prove here, right? Or and once we have locality, then we can associate to this Lie algebra a conformal superalgebra. But the question is, so is it enough to have locality to get this? Then there is a third part, which one needs to do is forms, so twisted forms. And so it turns out that we are falling short a little bit. So in order to have, suppose we have a graded Lie superalgebra of formal distributions. So when the corresponding superconformal algebra is finite. And so here, so one has to have an additional property of regularity, which we do not yet have for simple algebras. So let me say maybe what's a regular Lie superalgebra of formal distributions. Regular Lie superalgebra of formal distributions. So here what we need is we need to have a derivation of L such that our families or our formal distributions are decovariant. So this means that when we take the derivative of X of Z, then this is the same as D applied to X of Z component wise. Right. So if we have this property, then any regular Lie superalgebra of formal distributions generated or spanned by a finite family of mutually local D-covariant formal distributions, then this will give a finite simple conformal superalgebra. And unfortunately, so in the class of superconformal algebras, this regularity in general does not hold. So here we have an example of a non-regular superconformal algebra. So non-regular So this is a reason why we work in a general, more general class rather than restrict ourselves only to simple algebras, because in the general class, it's easier to construct various pathological examples. And then one only has to show that in simple algebras, these pathologies do not hold. Right. So again, so we have a Virasoro, and say we have the following. So Ln with um is minus m plus alpha n u n plus m, and Ln with vm is minus m plus alpha n v n plus m plus n u n plus m. Well, because of this additional extra term here, so it turns out that for this example, regularity will fail, and still locality holds here. So here, this is a Lie superalgebra of formal distributions. So there is locality, and thus one can associate the conformal superalgebra. But this conformal superalgebra is not going to be finite. So rather, this superalgebra is going to be a fine conformal superalgebra. So because locality, so we know that we have these kth products on conformal superalgebras, and kth products preserve locality. But also there is another operation on the fields or on the formal distributions. We can multiply by powers of Z. And so then this multiplication by powers of Z also preserves locality. And so on this conformal algebra, one can view it as a module not over DDZ, but also so we have a Weil algebra action. Right, so which is generated by the action of CZZ inverse and DDZ. So this is natural to call this conformal algebra affine if it has the Weil algebra action. And this case, so we get affine algebra, which is finitely generated over this Weil algebra. So it's not going to be finite in the sense of Fatorian cuts, but it will be affine algebra. All right. Now, so the last part that I want to talk about is quasi-Poisson algebras. So here, so we want to present a construction which is not a universal construction for a superconformal algebra. So not every superconformal algebra can be constructed in this way, but all simple superconformal algebras that we know, so they are constructed, so they can be constructed in this way. So here, so this idea, in fact, goes back to the old work of Novikov and Balinsky and Novikov, who defined Novikov algebras. But so this is a straightforward generalization of their construction, but somehow I didn't see this in the literature. So that's maybe somebody can tell me if this has been done and what's the reference. I would appreciate that. All right, so quasi-Poisson algebras. Now, suppose we have a finite dimensional algebra with the following operation, just dot multiplication, this bracket, and operator P, where P is an endomorphism of A. And I consider L of A to be an infinite dimensional space, which is CTT inverse tensor with A. And I want to introduce the following bracket on L of A. So I will denote AN will be T to the power N tensor A. So suppose we have AN with BM is N times A times P of B, N plus M minus M P of A times B, N plus M plus AB, N plus M. So this is Balinski-Novikov, almost Balinski-Novikov setup, except that they didn't have this last term. And so now the question, so when L of A is a superalgebra, a Lie superalgebra. And the answer to this is that when that A must be a quasi-Poisson algebra. So which means the following. So these are the axioms of a quasi-Poisson algebra. So one is that A with a dot is commutative. Two, A with curly thing is Lie superalgebra. Three, so the operator P satisfies the following condition. P applied to A times B is equal to P of A times B plus A times P of B minus A times B. And so the last axiom, which is the most interesting one. So let me take my cheat sheet. So it's like this. So A times P applied to BC is equal to A times P of B C plus, okay, I will write this in non-super case. In super case, there are obvious signs to be inserted. Plus AB times P of C minus P of B times AC. So if these, so this is four. So if these axioms hold, then L of A is going to be a Lie superalgebra. And so we can ask additionally, so when is L of A superconformal? So it's A, L of A is superconformal if we have two properties additionally. So we have one that A is unital, and one will generate a Virasoro subalgebra inside. And two is that a joint of one, in the sense of this Lie structure, is diagonalizable. So now, when Balinski and Novikov introduced Novikov algebras, so the big disappointment was, so there was a blow that Yefim Zelmanov dealt to their hopes that there are no non-trivial simple Novikov algebras. So in non-super case, there is just one-dimensional ones, and in super case, there are two-dimensional simple Novikov algebras. So here, so we have a meaningful and classifiable set of simple finite dimensional quasi-Poisson algebras, and they correspond to the conjectural list of superconformal algebras. Right. So let me give some examples. So of quasi-Poisson algebras. So if we have A a poisson with P equals identity operator plus D, where D is a derivation of A with a dot, and P is a derivation of A with curly brackets. Then, so this will satisfy the definition of a quasi-Poisson algebra. Now, so with this, we can give examples of simple superconformal algebras, or rather quasi-Poisson algebras that correspond to them. So now we start with the case K1M. So in this case, so A, we take the Grassmann algebra, lambda, and we introduce the we take the standard Poisson bracket. So the Poisson bracket of F and G is the sum I goes from 1 to N. So then we differentiate F with DI on the right times we differentiate G on the left, right? So this will be a Poisson algebra, and we have the usual multiplication. And so this is a simple quasi-Poisson algebra. So it's of this type. And it will, when we apply this L of A construction from this finite dimension algebra, we get type K. So in type W1M, we take the following. So A is going to be lambda, so same as before, plus derivations of lambda. So that's a Lie superalgebra. And the structure will be here the following. So when we multiply two functions, then this is just the usual product. So when we multiply function and the vector field, so this is just the usual operation of multiplication of a function by a vector field. And when we take two vector fields, the product is equal to zero. So when we take a Lie bracket of two functions, so that will be zero. The bracket of eta with f is eta of f, and the bracket of eta with tau is the usual commutator, right? And p of f is equal to f, and p of eta is zero, right? And so this is an example of a simple quasi-Poisson algebra. And the last example, if I have 1 minute, so this is the Chen-Katz algebra CK6. So here we take lambda of 6, and we consider the grading on this space. So we take K goes from 0 to 6. Lambda, well, we can use this notation. And we consider on the component lambda 6,3, we consider the operation which is called Hodge dual. So the Hodge dual of Xi I, Xi j, Xi k is Xi a, Xi b, Xi c, such that Xi I, Xi j, Xi k times Xi a, Xi b, Xi c is equal to Xi 1 to Xi 6. And so to define CK6, we take the space lambda 6,3 plus, which is the span of things like Xi I, Xi j, Xi k, plus square root of minus 1, Xi I, Xi j, Xi k dual. And then CK6 is going to be the sum k goes from 0 to 2 lambda 6.2 plus lambda 6.3 plus. So it turns out that this becomes a Lie subalgebra with respect to the usual Poisson bracket. And then the multiplicative structure also comes from lambda, right? So basically we can quotient out what's left, well, and twist a little bit the multiplication, and then we get a quasi-Poisson algebra defined on this space. And then when we take this construction and go to a super conformal algebra, then this quasi-Poisson algebra becomes exceptional, simple Chen Katz super conformal algebra. All right, so I will stop here.
Это мне кажется этот. А, Альберто, ну, смотря Альберто. Чё?
Окей. Any questions, comments? Questions, comments? So, Julie, excuse me. This endomorphism P is endomorphism of an algebra of a vector space.
So P is an endomorphism of A. Okay. So what we have here? I don't know why there is suddenly echo. So P has the structure its identity. And Novikov product is A circle T. So in terms of this endomorphism, the Novikov product is written like this. And by the way, so the axiom of quasi-Poisson algebra can be written alternatively in terms of Novikov product, right? So instead of having a commutative algebra and this endomorphism P, one can consider the Novikov product with Novikov algebra axioms and the Lie algebra structure, and so this additional axiom that ties them together.
Okay, more questions? Okay, if there are no questions, comments, let us thank Julie again. Very, very interesting talk.
Thank you.
I want just to remind that the next Thursday our seminar will start 4 hours early at 10 in Brazilian time, and we will have two talks by Professor Arakawa from Japan and Professor Kolesnikov from Russia, Novosibirsk. You can see the abstracts of talks at the web page of our seminar. And also there are recorded all previous lectures. So see you the next Thursday. Bye-bye.